Hi friends, welcome back to the new series JavaScript Zero to Hero. In this series, I'm explaining all the basic concepts in JavaScript. In this video, I'm going to talk about conditional statements in JavaScript. Conditional statements are used to execute some codes based on some conditions. Let me create a function that will accept a number as parameter. And I'm printing a sentence inside. And I am also calling this function and passing the argument as 15. Now I can see this sentence. Let me modify the sentence. Now I can see the updated sentence. And let me change the number to 50. If I execute now, I can see this. But it is not right. I want to display this only if the number is less than 25. In that case, I can use the conditional statement. In JavaScript, we can use if statement like this. So if I execute now, we can see this line of code is not executed. But if I change the number back to 15, we can see this line of code is now executed. Let me split this into two lines of code. Now we can see this. Okay, let me change the number to 35. Now we can see the first line of code is not executed because the condition is false. But this is executed. To avoid this, we can wrap the entire block of code inside curly braces, like this. Now we can see the expected result. Actually, curly braces are not needed when we need to control a single line of code. But to control multiple lines, we need to have curly braces. But it is recommended to use curly braces even for controlling a single line of code. Okay, when the number is greater than 25, right now we are not printing anything. Instead, let us print something like the number is greater than 25. For that, we have else condition, like this. So if I execute, we can see the number is greater than 25. What will happen if you pass 25? It is printing the number is 25 and it is greater than 25. That is not right. So we need to have another condition to check whether the number is equal to 25. We can have multiple conditions using ELSEIF. Let me modify this else to ELSEIF. And finally, let me have the else block. Now it is working. And one more thing, as this line of code is present in all blocks, we can simply remove and put it before the if-else blocks. Let's see another example. Let me create a new function to calculate the grade based on mark. If the mark is greater than 90, I need to print A grade. If the mark is lesser than 90 and greater than 70, I need to print B grade. And if the mark is lesser than 70 and greater than 50, I need to print C grade. And if the mark is lesser than or equal to 50, I need to print fail. Let me test it. When I pass the mark as 55, we can see C grade. So it seems to be working, but actually not. Let me pass the mark as 75. Now we can see both B grade and C grade. Because when the mark is 75, it satisfies these two conditions and so both the code will execute. So here also we can use ELSEIF instead of if. When I change this to ELSEIF, we can see it is working. Because when it is if, regardless of whether the previous condition is true or false, it tries to evaluate the current condition. But when it is ELSEIF, it evaluates the current condition only when the previous condition is false. And so it won't execute all blocks. We can have any number of ELSEIF, but we can have only one else. apart from if else, we have another conditional statement in JavaScript, that is switch case. Let us see one example. Let me have a number 3. And then let me create a switch statement. Here we can give any expression. For now, let me give the number itself. And I can create the cases. Like this. Let me test it. We can see it is executing the code inside this case because this is what getting matched. Let me change the number to 2. Now we can see the codes from both the cases 2 and 3. That is because switch case will execute all the below codes when there is a match. To prevent that, we can break the execution using break statement like this. Now we can see only the case 2 is executed. What will happen if I change the number to 5? We can see nothing is getting printed. But we can provide a default block. Like this. Now we can see when there is no matching case, the code inside default is getting executed. And if there is a match, default block will be ignored. This is how we can use switch statement. So if you have a requirement to execute an expression which returns true or false, and based on that you need to execute something, you can go for if else. And if you have a requirement to execute an expression which returns a value from a set of values, and based on the value you want to execute something, you can go for switch case. That's all about conditional statements. If you like this video, please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.